Hello YouTube, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss vouchers. Yesterday we did friendship, so today we are doing vouchers. So how do you get vouchers? In Classic, by defeating a new gym leader or Elite Four, you get an Egg Voucher Plus, which is 5. If you defeat a champion, that's 10, so that's a premium, and after that it's 1. Completing Classic mode the first time is a voucher gold, that's 25, and after that it's a premium, so that's 10. And you have ribbons, so for any new Pokemon that finishes Classic, you have 5. So 5 times 6 for the beginning, right? So you get 6 Voucher Plus, which is 30 eggs. Daily run gives 10. You want to do the daily run if you liked doing it, but if you're doing it for the Voucher, it's not really worth, to be honest. One Classic run, which on the later part of the game. But if you are new, do the daily run, actually. If you are new, do the daily run. But if you are like on your like 100 Classic runs to farm vouchers, don't do the daily run. But I will explain after that. In Endless, you get a Voucher Plus, which is a blue one every 50 floors. And on 250, you get a premium, which is a purple one. So now we are going to discuss the notepad. So, again, we have the daily run. If you are new, do the daily run. That's great. Let's do the numbers for Endless. So in Endless, I would say the average end time is 44 hours. So that's 1 day and 20 hours. I've seen some people do it in 1 day. My two runs are actually pretty close to that. It's I have one at 1 day and one at 1 day and 24 hours and 22 hours. Sorry, those are my runs for me. And sometimes we have 3 hours, not 3 hours, 3 days runs, or 1 day and 20 hours, or 1 day. So I would say the average is somewhere in 44 hours. Of course, you can speedrun Endless and do it in like 9, 10 hours, or 7 hours even. But it's that's not the average, right? So each 50 gives a blue, every 250 gives a purple. We have 5850 floors. So here, if we check 5750 first, and we divide by 250, you know, if we check 5750 divided by 250, that's 23 times, 23 iteration plus 2 blue, so that's 4 times 23, because we have 4 blues, and 2 blues, because we have 5.8k and 5850, plus 2, that's 94, then we have a purple as well, so that's 1 times 23, 23 purple. And for the shop, we have normal vouchers in yellow rarity and blue vouchers in master ball rarity. So here I would say, so that's purple rarity, by the way. My best for me in 250 floors for an iteration was 1 purple, 14 blues and 11 normal. So this is counting the bosses, of course. But if we remove the bosses, we have 10 blues and 11 normals. That was actually my best. On average, I would say you can find every 250 floors, 2 blues and 3 normals. I was actually nice here, because sometimes it's way, way more. Especially if you're looking for them in the late game. You can actually look for them in the late game. It's very, very easy to find those Egg Voucher Plus, because you have so much money, right? But of course, the run takes more than 44 hours, but the average like goes way higher. Anyways, we have 23 iteration, right? So that's 2 times 23, that's 46 blue. And 3 times 23, that's 69 normal vouchers, and we add everything together. So 94 plus 46, 23 purple, and 69 normal. That's what we have here. So 23 times 10 is 230, 140 times 5 is 700, 69 times 1 is 69, so we have 1000 egg on average for a run. You need to take into account that you have 4 shiny charms, which is 1 in 32 chance to find a shiny. So if we do, let's say that you get your 4 shiny charms after 1000. So let's do 4850 divided by 32. I would say that's 150 shinies and 20 legendaries on a run. So that's what you get. 1000 eggs, 150 shinies, 20 legendaries. That's your reward. So now let's check. So this is of course not related to vouchers, but of course if you are doing vouchers, most of the time you're looking for either shinies or legendaries, right? Now Classic. Okay, so I've separated Classic in 4 scenarios, I would say. We have the first scenario where you are a newbie. You have all vouchers available, your 6 rebounds, and this is your first 9 runs, which is specifically your 9 first wins. Let's say you win 9 times, which never happens, but let's say you do, right? Perfect scenario here. 5 hours, I would say, is the average for a newbie. I've seen people go for 7-8 hours. Some people take 3 or 4. It depends on how they are at Pokemon overall and if they stream or not or whatever. But I've seen Alpharad, I've seen Ludwig, I've seen all those streamers who they run for the first time. I've seen some videos on YouTube. So I would say most of the time, 5 hours for your first 10 runs is acceptable. It's the average, probably. So we have 6 rebounds, that's 6 blue. 6 blue for 6 new gym leaders. 4 new E4, so that's 4 blue. 1 new champion, that's 1 purple. 1 new end, so that's 1 gold. It's not your first time finishing the game. And 1 end after that, it's 1 purple. So that's 1 blue and 2 normal in the shop. So most of the time, you're going to find a Master Ball Rarity Egg Voucher. Sometimes you don't find one. Sometimes you find 2. I would say the average is probably 1. And then 2 normals. Every time you see a normal Egg Voucher, just take it. It's better than everything else in the shop. That's 2 normal, 17 blue. So 6 plus 6 plus 4 plus 1. So that's 6, 12, 16, 17. We have 1 purple, so that's 18 purple in total, but 1 gold, because you finish once. So that's 2 purple times 9, which is 17 purple plus 1 gold. So again, 2 normal from the shop, 17 blue in total from all your run, 2 purple times 9, because we have 9 runs. That's going to be 18 normal, 153 blue, 17 purple, and only 1 gold. So here, if we do the math, at 153 times 5, that's 765, 170, 25, that's 978 eggs for your first runs. All right. Now we have the second scenario. So let's say you are after your 10 runs, and now you don't really have any Elite Four left, and you still have half the gym leaders to find. And let's say you find half of them, right, for this specific scenario. I would say now your end time is going to be 2 hours on average, because you know how Classic Run works now. You know the Pokemons, you know when the gym leaders are going to appear. You know where they are, you know how to find them, how to track them down. Easy peasy, right? So 2 hours, I would say. That's my average, to be honest, with a non-legendary team. So 44 divided by 2 is 22 runs. So we have 4 rebounds because you're going to have one of your favorite Pokemon. It's something you bring, like something specific for the Eternatus or whatever. So 4 new Pokemons, that's 4 blue vouchers. 3 new gym leaders, that's 3 blue vouchers. 3 normal, that's 3 normal vouchers. 4 normal for Elite 4 because those are not new, so no Elite 4, right? 1 end is always a purple one. And again, 1 blue and 2 normal in shop. So we have 10 normal, because we have 3 plus 4. Plus 1, that's 7 plus 1, 8, plus 2, 10. 8 blue, that's 4 rebounds, 3 new gym leaders, and a blue in the shop, that's 8. Why did I say 2 purple here? That's 1 purple. Yeah, the math is actually correct. I have 22 at the bottom, but I have 2 here. I don't know why, whatever. So 220 normal, 176 blue, and 22 purple. Let's do 176 times 5 just to make sure. So 220 plus 880 plus 220. That's going to be 1320 eggs. There you go. This is for the after when you are okay with Classic and you're farming it specifically for vouchers or a normal run, I would say. Okay? 1320 eggs. Not bad, huh? Now we have the last one. This is where I am currently and where most of you are, I guess. At this point, you have Zacian and you do rush runs, which takes like 1 hour and 10 minutes in average. My best being 45 and my worst being like 1 hour and 25 minutes or something. That's 38 runs. So now we have no vouchers. We have all of them, or sometimes we find one, but it's very rare. We have all of it. 4 rebounds because we have Zacian, which is always the same. And we bring like maybe 1 Pokemon that we want to deal with, Rayquaza or something like that, which you don't really need. But sometimes it's going to be hard at this point to find 5 new Pokemon. So I would say 4 in average is the acceptable here. So 1 hour and 10 minutes, 4 rebounds, that's 4 blues. We have plus 1 in the shop, so that's 5 blues here. 1 purple for the end, of course. And we have 13 normal, so that's 6 gym leader. 4 elite 4, 1 champion, so 6 plus 10 plus 1 is 11, plus 2 is 13. So that's 13 times 38, so times 30, that's 494. 5 times 38 is 190. And 38 purple, of course, so that's 494. That's 190 times 5, that's 950. So we have 494 plus 950 plus 390. That's 1824 eggs. So that's the sweet spot here, to be honest. This is where I am currently. This is where I farm all my ribbons. I'm running out, though, into the next scenario, but we're going to talk about it. Actually, let's switch into it. But this is definitely the sweet spot, those two scenarios here. This is definitely the spot where you're having fun. And I guess this is not really fun. This is very mechanical because you only play Zacian. It's very boring, like Endless, to be honest. But there you go. So now we have the last scenario. This is the point where we are all going to be at some point. No ribbons, no vouchers, nothing. This is where I was before the ribbon update, to be honest. So that's still the same run, still the same runtime, nothing changed. But you have no extra rewards. So no ribbons anymore. So we remove all the blues except one from the shop. And two normal. So we have 6 plus 10, 6 plus 4 plus 1, that's 11 plus 2, that's 13 normal. One purple for the end, one blue for the shop. I would say changing the champion into a blue would be pretty cool, to be honest. Like, it would be a pretty big deal, I'm not gonna lie. But, you know, whatever. So same here, 13 times 38 is gonna be 494. We have 38 blues and 38 purples. 38 times 5 is 190. And we have times 2 for 390. That's 1,064 eggs. So, here I would say, if you are in this spot here, and you are specifically farming for vouchers, if you're a newcomer, you don't care about vouchers. You care about clearing classic because that's what you do. If you are in this spot where you are trying to figure out if you want to farm classic for vouchers specifically, and you are in this spot here, this is the sweet spot because you get a lot of eggs if you do rush runs, or if you do team runs, right? Those are gonna be fine. You get more eggs than in Endless, that's for sure. But you get less shinies and less legendaries. After that, you get back to 1,000 eggs, so there is really no point in doing this anymore. You're better off going in Endless. To make a conclusion here, I would say that it is better than to farm Classic. Overall, it's fun to do this with like new teams every time. Zacian runs are as boring as Endless, that's for sure. But you get more eggs, that's 1,800. That's way more than Endless. But again, you need to take into account that when you do Endless, you are gonna get probably more than the average, right? In this line specifically, you might get more than 2 blues in between floors. As I said, my best was like 10. So that's actually insane. If you're looking specifically for vouchers, which I'm doing, and I guess most people are doing in Endless, you are actually get like way more than the average, that's for sure. You can go into 1.2k, 1.3k easy, like very easy here, even more. And you get the shinies plus the legendaries. Keep playing Classic. Keep doing your runs, your like rush runs with Zacian once you have him. You can still play off something else than Zacian, right? You can play Zacian plus something else and you can switch and have fun. But if you do rush runs, that's your number here. And I would say this is better than Endless, probably. But you're going to run out of rebounds very quickly. After your 38 runs, you're going to go like lower and lower. You're going to go to 3 rebounds and 2 rebounds and 1 rebound and 0. It's just going down from here. Yeah, once you are in this scenario here and you don't have anything else new, you're better off doing Endless, for sure. Don't skip yellow vouchers, don't skip the Master Ball ones. Just go for them every single time, reroll for them in the late game, and there you go. So that's gonna be it for me. I hope this video was helpful as well. Let me know your times in the comments or something. Let me know what are your strats, your times, I guess. Yeah, that's it for me. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.